It is currently 3:21 a.m. and I have a flight in 3 hours.
Where I'm gonna hop on a plane from San Francisco, fly my ass out to Minnesota, St. Paul, to go see freaking Suni Lee at a parade. This is absolutely insane. And my dog agrees.
Alright, let's get out of bed and let's friggin' do this, I guess. Let's friggin' go see Suni Lee.
Hands in your body, I'm grabbing your ass. Enjoying the moment, cause life moved too fast. I'm looking forward, ignoring the past. These are the times that we'll laugh looking back. I'm getting lucky like coins in a well. Goodbye to my haters, I'm wishing you well. This is my amen, if you couldn't tell. This is our life and we living it well. Late nights in the city causing hell. Burn this bitch into the ground, oh well. All we got tonight, let's do this right. Let's do this right. Let's go to
paradise. This shit be like Friday nights. This shit made me feel alive. I feel like we in paradise. Paradise. Don't know if it's a drink I pour.
Yeah, paradise, yeah, yeah. It's somewhere that I've never been before. Yeah, I just wanna be there when I wake up. Yeah, like you better with no makeup. Yeah, yeah, paradise, yeah. It's somewhere that I've never been before. Yeah, I just wanna be there when I wake up. Yeah, like you better with no makeup.
Nick, you're stupid.
It hurt way more than it should. I knew that it would. I lost myself along the way. You make it hard.
She don't wanna believe that it ended how it did. When I told her to leave, had to tell her what it is. She was stuck in a dream, thinking that it never ends. You can blame it on me, you could blame it on me. She don't wanna believe that it ended how it did. When I told her to leave, had to tell her what it is. She was stuck in a dream, thinking that it never ends. You can blame it on me, you could blame it on me.
Everybody get your motherfucking roll on. I know shorty and she doesn't want no slow song. Had a man last year, life goes on. Haven't let the thing loose, girl, in so long. You been inside, know you like to lay low. I been peeping what you bringin' to the table. Working hard, girl, everything paid for. First, last phone bill, car, no cable. With your phone out, gotta hit them angles. With your phone out, snapping like you Fabo. And you showing off, but it's alright. And you showing off. But it's alright, it's a short life. That's a real one in your reflection. Without a follow, without a mention. You really piping up on these niggas. You gotta be nice for what?
I'm trying to get everything.
Thank you. Okay, this is the point in the video where I'm gonna interject with my own random, unasked for thoughts. It was really cool to see an entire community come together to celebrate the success of one of their own. There are people of all ages, ethnicities, genders, everything you could name out there showing their support for Suni, this local hero. And it felt especially meaningful that she was Asian American. Personally, as an Asian American, I've always felt like there were too many cultural roadblocks that were too hard for me to overcome for me to be truly American, whatever that means. But here's Suni, Hmong American and all, American hero. And on the Hmong American note, my friend mentioned to me that it felt especially significant that Suni was Hmong. It felt cool that this historically mistreated group of people got to watch one of their own get this huge win. I mean, this is what the older generation always wants, right? For their kids to have a better life. And Suni was proof that everything the older generation did was worth it. There are so many people who are just proud to be Hmong, and so many kids who you could tell were realizing that they too could do anything they wanted to do and be anyone they wanted to be. One thing that sticks out to me as pretty touching during the whole thing was when Suni's mom said that Suni was everyone who was theirs' daughter. It was kind of tear-jerking, you know? This thanks from a mother to a community that she knows also raised her kid. It takes a village. It felt like what Suni did went beyond gymnastics or the Olympics. It felt like she really pulled all these people together on her own and gave them a reason to be family and neighbors again. At one point during the celebration, Suni's dad asked his entire extended family to come up to the stage. And there must have been over 50 people who got up there, this huge delegation, and it was pretty touching to see, you know? You could feel the love they all had for each other. And I think that's what I took away the most from the whole thing, the beauty of belonging, this unbreakable bond and the never-ending love that pours forth from that, among family, among friends, and among community.
It is that time. Please help me welcome gold medal Olympian, Suni Salih.
Thank you to City of St. Paul and Visit St. Paul, and most importantly, my whole entire family and everybody else just for coming out to see me. This is truly amazing. It's not like anything I ever expected. So to see all of your amazing faces here is just truly incredible. Thank you. I want to say that if you ever want to reach your dreams, please try and go for it, because you never know how far you're going to get. And it's just truly is amazing when you do reach your dreams. So please don't ever, ever, even if it get hard, like, don't ever stop. And keep reaching for your dreams. I'm gonna give her a break. Everyone wants you to sing a song, but she's not gonna do that.
Okay? I don't know how to sing.
If you were not an Olympic athlete, what career would you be pursuing?
Singing.
Okay. I don't know how to sing.
No, don't ask me to sing.
How you gonna say you wanna be a singer and then don't wanna sing?
I don't know how to sing.
She can do flips, she can do the uneven bar. She's not gonna sing.
Yes.
They want a lot from you.
They do
want a lot from you.
I'm gonna go to the hospital. Now you tryna do you, but I heard you fell off. After a couple bad nights and 20 cold hearts. Tryna find a new you, but I heard you got lost. Tryna figure your worth, what the hell does that cost? When I'm kissing you, gripping your thigh, I realize you were destined and meant to be mine. But who am I to conflict with you living your life? Just know when you call, I'm at the end of the line. I'll practice my patience while you're getting wasted. Till fate brings you home, I'll wait through your phases. You'll shuffle through phases like songs in your playlist. Till fate brings you home, I'll wait through your phases. Too far. It doesn't matter where it takes you, I go wherever you are. When I'm kissing you, gripping your thigh, I realize you were destined and meant to be mine. But who am I to conflict with you living your life? Just know when you go, I'm at the end of the line. I'll practice my patience. Tired of being soft-spoken. You got me broken, writing songs about you daily, and it's messing with my focus. You fuck with him, but we both realize that he was bogus. I'm the one for you, so why do I feel like I go and notice? Talking more than clothes hitting floors. I'm falling off track, but not direct, like a chore. But look, another butterfly.
What's up, guys? It's your boy, Introverted Madness. Just want to hit you guys with some quick sad boy hours. It's pretty late at night over here, and I just got finished editing this video, and I figured, let's just speak from the heart. I tried writing a script out for this, like, multiple times, but super failed, so this is me going scriptless. I feel like I should explain why I traveled 2,000 miles to see Suni Lee, because that's a pretty weird thing to do. The truth of the matter is, I am down bad, quite bad for Suni Lee. I got myself a little celebrity crush there, and it kind of feels weird, to be honest, because I know that I literally don't know who Suni Lee is. She's a total stranger to me. I only know who she is based on her Instagram posts and 10-minute interviews on YouTube, so obviously that isn't, like, who she actually is, so if I have a celebrity crush, I have a crush on kind of this imaginary person that I have created in my head about Suni. And obviously, Suni doesn't know who I am. She literally has no idea I even exist, because there's probably thousands of thirsty dudes like me on the internet. So that's a little weird. Yeah, I don't know. I feel like it's a kind of, it is creepy, and is like the first step towards having a restraining order put out against me, I guess, so that's not so great. Yeah, that's not great. I feel like the reason behind the celebrity crush is because I've been feeling kind of lonely lately. Yeah, I don't know. I go through this cycle with, like, the dating apps where I feel lonely. I'm like, I'm gonna be single forever. Fuck. And I download Tinder. I hop on Tinder. I use it for 5 days. I get super depressed, selling my soul for the algorithm to find me love, and also getting no matches and realizing I'm ugly and no one ever will want me. And yeah, that causes me to get depressed. I delete the apps, and then eventually I start to feel lonely again, and the cycle repeats itself. That sucks. I feel like love is pretty hard to find nowadays, because everyone is just so emotionally... I feel like everyone has like an emotional trauma that they're carrying with them nowadays. There's just so much that's fucked up about the world. People just carry that shit with them, and it's probably been that way throughout history. And there's probably most certainly been worse times in history to be alive, but... Yeah, I don't know. In the modern day, with the algorithms and the internet and the... It just makes finding love seem like kind of just transactionary or meaningless, and that kind of sucks, so... Love is dead. That's what I have to say. And I guess because love is dead, my mind has gone completely bonkers. And, like, in my head, it's just as easy. I have just as much of a chance of getting with freaking Suni Lee as anyone, because anyone, what a miracle it is to find anyone in this world, right? So if I'm gonna go crazy and find love, might as well go all the way and have a crush on Suni Lee, right? Yeah, man, I don't know. Life is hard. Love is dead. But I don't know. We gotta keep going, right? We gotta have hope, because that's the only thing that keeps us going as humans, is that we hope that we'll figure it out. And I don't know. I think there's a chance we figure it out. So, Suni, if you're listening to this, I got a degree from Stanford. I got a stable job. I can cook. I have a car, so if all those, you know, adult-ass things interest you, hit me up. Alright, it's getting too late for this shit. Alright, peace.